It's great to be here at Minot State University and to participate with the North Dakota All-State Band. And I must say, they're magnificent students. They're well-prepared and they're well-disciplined. I've tried to choose a program that represents some of the finest examples of the band repertoire, with various styles, largely American, but also some from the British Isles as well. We open with the Puccinello Overture of the American composer Alfred Reed. He calls it a romantic comedy. It's in three parts, an ABA form. The A forms is a light two-step comedy. The middle form is a beautiful romantic setting. You'll be able to close your eyes and hear an accordion and a mandolin player and imagine that you're in the romantic city of Venice.
Thank you.
We'll next do Semper Fidelis March of John Philip Sousa, the great American march king. It represents, I think, the finest of John Philip Sousa's marches and has a chance to feature the trumpet section, the percussion section, and also the dynamic contrast that many people feel lack in military marches. It has a real flair and the kids have a lot of fun with it. We continue with the English Folk Song Suite by the English composer Ralph Vaughan Williams, or Ralph Vaughan Williams if you're in England. It's in three movements, and it's based on English folk songs that he collected in the early part of this century throughout the British Isles. Vaughan Williams, Gustav Holst, Cecil Sharp, and others would wander around the English countryside, go to the local pub, have the local singer sing folk songs for them, and they'd jot them down. And these English melodies became a very important part of Vaughan Williams' compositional style. The three songs, a fast, a slow, and a fast, give various instruments a chance to solo as well. The kids have enjoyed it very much. And it was one of the first compositions that Vaughan Williams wrote for the military band. And he opened up a new world as far as band is concerned, and it's become one of the standard pieces of our repertoire today. Thank you. we conclude with a beautiful, probably the most loved patriotic American song, America the Beautiful, written by Samuel Ward and put in a beautiful, lush setting by Carmen Dragon. The band plays it magnificently. And I'm very proud, particularly, I've been in Germany for the past 4 years, serving the United States Air Force at Ramstein Air Force Base in Germany. Emotionally, it means a great deal to me as well to come home. This is labeled the hymn tune, Materna is the name of it now, meaning motherland or mother country. And the kids just do a magnificent job with this setting.
Thank you. Well, this is my first visit to Minot, and I've driven through here with the family on about three different occasions when we drove from Seattle going back east or coming back from the east back to Seattle. But I had never stopped here. We had never visited here. Maybe I picked up gasoline. But coming together with these young people who are together for the first time, many of them are strangers to each other, and of course I'm a stranger to them, is a great challenge because it takes a great deal to pull everybody together in what we call a fine ensemble. And it's very challenging because they wonder what I'm about, you know, they're not used to my methods, in other words. But after, I would say, a half hour or so, they began to warm up and we began to play together. And I always concentrate on two things at the very beginning, that they play together and play in tune. And I'd stress those things above everything else. And then we began talking about the music, about phrasing and that type of thing. And speaking of music, the first thing on the program will be a very brilliant work called Matador. And I've kind of chosen our first trumpet player as the Matador because he has some solos along the way and he gets a big kick out of it. I tell him to, as a matter of fact, I told him to dress up like a Matador tonight. I hope he doesn't, but he may, I'm not sure, because some of them take you at your word, you know. I've had percussion players in our youth symphony. If we were doing a Spanish number, they come with Mexican hats and all that type of thing, you know. But anyway, I'm enjoying the work very, very much. And the first work is very brilliant. And the reason I chose it is because it's going to really lift the audience, you know, the spirits of the audience right from the very beginning.
Thank you.
What we're doing for the second number is called the passacaglia, which is an Italian term for a variation form. And this is an old tune, an old English tune. As a matter of fact, the piece is called Passacaglia on a well-known tune or a well-known theme. And a very well-known English composer by the name of Gordon Jacob has taken this tune and written variations on it. And it starts with a solo horn, and then it develops from there into a tremendous climax at the end. Everybody has a crack at the theme somewhere along the way. And the next piece that we play is called Folk Song Rhapsody by Claire Grundemann. And it's made up of all sorts of well-known American themes. Beautiful, beautiful tunes. I think everybody in the audience will recognize them when they hear them. And I've chosen it for the reason that it's a great contrast between the Passacaglia, the second number, and the last number. And it's something which is not as bright and not as brilliant as the other pieces on the program, but something that will act as a very fine contrast. And the last is the blockbuster. This is the Great Gate of Kiev. And that comes from the pictures in an exhibition by Mussorgsky. And this is Mussorgsky wrote that for piano. And then it was orchestrated by Ravel, the famous French composer Ravel. He orchestrated that. The version that we're doing is not Ravel, but it's based on Ravel's orchestration. A man by the name of Reibel did it. And that is the big, big number for the orchestra. I mean, we even had to pull in some extra players for this one.
Thank you. And the choral selections tonight were chosen from a variety of styles. The students that participate in this organization need to experience a variety of styles, so we chose some that were sacred, some that were secular, some that were fast, some slow, some old, some new, to give them as great a musical experience as possible. The first selection is a piece by Dan Moe called Hosanna to the Son of David. It's for organ and choir, and it's a very alive, vibrant, exciting, up-tempo piece in a contemporary style. It's presented a very great challenge for the students, has a lush, slow section in the middle, and ends with a big screaming ending. The next selection is Shenandoah. Everyone knows this melody. This is an arrangement by James Erb, and it's divided into eight parts. The men's section, we have high school students singing low C's through the whole thing, and for those singers in the audience, we know that's extremely difficult to do. Big, full, lush sound, and a beautiful arrangement of an old mountain ballad, Shenandoah.
Thank you.
Felix Mendelssohn wrote a variety of symphonic and choral works. We'll be doing A Star Shall Rise Up Out of Jacob, which is a part of a larger piece and is written especially for the Advent season. Mendelssohn rediscovered Bach, and which is difficult for us to believe now, but Bach's music was almost lost. And he, in rediscovering it, he copied a lot of the elements of Bach's music. So you'll be able to hear, even though it's in romantic style, little touches of Bach style in especially the chorale at the end of the piece, A Star Shall Rise Up Out of Jacob.
Thank you.
The Evensong to God by Franz Joseph Haydn is a piece in classical style. Now, we misuse sometimes the term classical to mean just any sort of classical music, but this is a piece written in a particular style period that we've labeled a classical style. The Minot Chamber Orchestra is going to join the choir on this selection, and the essence of this piece is a melody that repeats over and over and over again in all the various voice parts. And it's a very lovely melody that that speaks of coming to the end of the day. Evensong to God.
Thank you.
And now for something really different. The Obey the Spirit of the Lord is a spiritual by Robert DeCormier. It's a rollicking, foot-stomping gospel piece. It features two soloists that were selected from the choir, Connie Coleman and Patrick Blendauer. And it's one of those pieces that you just sort of sit back and enjoy, feel the beat, and wait for the big ending. Obey the Spirit of the Lord.